In this video, I'm going to show you maintenance secrets to long-lasting use of a biodigester. Now, on this channel, we do videos that explain to homeowners how to construct biodigesters and use it as an option in terms of managing their solid waste. We also do videos that basically shows you how to construct a simple on-site biodegradable toilet with biodigester. I'm in the business of biodigester construction, and I have constructed over thousands of biodigesters. In this video, I'm going to give you biodigester maintenance secrets to long-lasting use of your biodigester. So I did a video about how I constructed the newly designed soakaways for homeowners and how I've tried this one particular soakaway with a family right here in Accra. And basically, they have been using this biodigester for 1 year, but then I got a call about a problem that they're having because of the soakaway, and I have to show up on site. Initially, when we showed up on site, we were not sure what has led to the water that was seeping out of the ground.
I don't know what it is, right there was full of water.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what this is.
Yes.
Yeah, we have messed with it since. And the water was just flowing that way.
So the water, sometimes it comes.
That's the only time.
That's the only time it came.
Yeah.
And it rained? Not really.
It wasn't raining that day or the day before.
Okay.
And this is the only area that was wet.
Yeah. Because it shouldn't be.
To me. The water wasn't coming like out of here.
It was
just kind of around the base.
Okay.
And that was what
where was it was going out. But the inside?
But
like toilet?
Yeah.
In the room.
Mm-hmm. Mostly in this.
Okay.
In this back.
Okay. So what? We could open this one, see. It's your dream.
Yeah.
Okay.
But they hadn't done it since that day.
Yeah.
But it was like at night.
Mm-hmm.
And we was getting ready to go to, we'd been taking a shower and everything. And it was like really strong. And boom, smelled in the bedroom in here.
Yeah.
And then we came out here. Water was all
over.
Mm-hmm. So,
if you get this smell inside, it's 99% of the time not from here.
Okay.
It should be a plumbing issue.
Yeah.
Because probably the ceiling, the vents,
yeah,
or whatever was supposed to be covered, wasn't covered well.
Yeah.
If there's anything, it should go out through the vents if that's available on the distance.
Yeah, we haven't smelled anything since then. And then what I did was grab the water hose and just spray all of the water
away.
And we didn't smell anything after that.
Yeah.
It happened since.
Yeah.
We don't know why it happened.
Because if there was the building, if there was anything, they went to open this one,
mm-hmm.
they're supposed to hear it.
Oh, really?
Yes.
And so it'll make some type of noise?
No, you hear the scent. Open it up.
Okay. Uh-huh.
You're supposed to hear the smell, the odor and things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It don't like to happen that
only
night.
Only that time. Yeah.
And it had to happen.
That hasn't happened.
I don't know why it happened.
Mm.
I just know that was full of water.
Yeah.
Like I said, there was little water around this thing, but I couldn't see what was leaking.
Yeah. And the other one has not provided, giving you any, that problem?
No.
Yeah. Incident. Okay. So what I will do is, what you say, then? What should we do? What we'll do is, let's observe it and see how it goes. Okay. If there's any new update, then probably we'll come and take it off and then do some cleaning inside.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
But for now, because I can't see anything really, which is the problem now.
Like I said, it hasn't happened again. Like it happened that night.
Mm. That's why.
I can still smell something, so I got the water hose and this
to get it away. But the water that was here, was it toilet water?
It had a smell.
Yeah.
I don't.
You know, so if it's a stagnant water, any stagnant water smells.
Yeah.
Even though it might not be toilet water necessarily.
Yeah.
It could be bathroom water or kitchen water.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out what
had
happened because we were. Like, I was doing work around here all day.
And
during the day,
there was nothing.
And then when we was getting ready to take a shower that night, we walked in the room, and it was like, man, what's that smell?
Mm-hmm.
And that toilet, I think my wife said there was like not a whole lot of water in it.
Yeah.
And so I came out here and looked, and that's when we saw that. So
oh.
We started filming it and sent it to the platform.
Yes.
We didn't know what that was. That was where the water was really coming from and the smell.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's okay then.
Yeah.
All right. I'll do a video and ask on the platform if they know what that is.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And then,
but it hasn't happened again.
Yes. So let's wait and see.
Okay.
Sometimes it's good because it's a new property and this is a new thing you're using. You need to also observe it and see if there are any stuff on it. Yeah.
No problem. So, it has to give us any problems, no smells or nothing. Yeah. So,
okay.
Yeah, since we got what?
Yeah. Well, I'll let me check the other one. Oh, you don't really use this side. Okay. So how many toilets? Yeah, it should be two.
So we got two on this side and two on the other.
Okay. This is the one that we did it was hidden. We did this one.
So this one.
We might still need a slab on it. And then it is okay.
Yeah.
We might need a slab on it.
Here.
Yeah. We might need a slab on it. If I don't know, if they are coming to work in it and we can get them to do a slab. No. We'll just put a slab on it, not necessarily to seal it, but to just leave it on it. So that when it rains, the water doesn't stay from there's a chemical that we can get and then occasionally flush it through the WC.
Yeah.
But usually I do that when it's about a year and two. Yes,
you just put it down the toilet.
Yeah, you just flush it occasionally.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Just to, in case, sometimes there's also a blockage.
Yeah.
Soak away. The soak away is way, way, way down, hidden under the ground. So the key to all this conversation is that whenever you do control the biodigester and you have left the ground, you have left the site and your work has been done, it's still good to keep an eye on what's going on in terms of what is happening on the site. So for this particular project, what we did was to hide the soak away. It was hidden under the ground so that whenever the concrete or pavement is done, it will be completely buried, just like how you can see from the other side of the property. But apparently when the groundwork was being done, they thought that they seen the soak away there, and then the good thing for them, the ideal thing for them was to project it up. But by projecting it up, it still need to be covered. Otherwise, any small leakage, it will show up in the house. And if there's any smell or there's any scent, it will obviously be part of the problem that they'll be having in the house. And that's what happened to this particular digester. And then the problem that it came with the soak away. So what we have done is simple. We have come to take out all the water from the soak away because basically it has been rendered ineffective. With the water that's seeping out, it means that the ground has already become soggy and it's not going to soak well. So what we are going to do or what we are doing is basically to take out the water, drain all the water from it, and then go ahead and put a top slab on it so that we can always have access to the water next time it needed to be collected. It can be collected out of the soak away that we did for this particular digester. What we are doing is just extend the soak away, and this time we are going to give it an access by putting a top slab on it so that anytime there's an issue, we can always have access to it instead of the way it was. We have come to do the correction. The issue, as I've said severally, was because of the access that was given to this side of the soak away. Ideally, it should have been buried under the concrete, and then probably the sand will seep under it. What we have done is to take out the blocks and then give it a top slab as well as an access to the wastewater. So the idea is that because there was an opening to the soak away, whenever the water gets full, obviously, there was an outlet, so it was coming out. And that's why they were smelling the water. And then the scent was over the place. But right now, what we have done is to give it an access. So in case, in the worst case scenario, that the water comes up and then it gets filled up and then probably they are pumping they're flushing the water from the house and they can't get it right, then we can come and have an access to this place here and probably pump the water out if there need be. So we have given it an access now. And I think that's what we're going to help in the long term to solve the problem that we have. So this is a digester. What we did was to have the water seep out physically, have the water physically removed from the soakaway that was coming out because of the block work that was done here. So what we have done right now is to have the block work taken out, and then we've had an access to the soakaway itself, and we've taken out much of the water from the ground. And now we have given it a clean out together with a top slab so that we can always have an access to the water in case it does come up. So my recommendation is to have a small size pump, and then probably every 6 months or every 1 year, depending on the situation, and then we have an access to it. We put a pump on it and then we pump the water into the garden. That will be our solution for now. The initial idea was that the water must be hidden underground and that the concrete work is going to cover it all over the place. It's going to cover it so that nothing comes up. But because of the access that was given to it from the block work that was done here, that's why the water was coming out. And then it was causing the mayhem and the problem it was causing. But right now we have sorted it out by giving it and doing it like this.